And I got a, this is big, someone who's been in the news a lot lately to co-host with me. It's pretty cool to be able to get him in here. There's a lot of questions I have, and I'd like him to answer for some things. Everybody, from Surviving R. Kelly documentary, R. Kelly in studio right now. Robert, how are you?
I'm good. Robert Kelly.
Mm-hmm. Well, now, of course.
Yeah, well, he's good. I mean, calling yourself R. Kelly after all the shit that's raining down on you right now?
Well, I mean, I think you call me Bobby Kelly.
Well, I know you.
Yeah.
I was unfamiliar. I didn't know. It was before documentary days, I guess.
I did a documentary called Torgasm. Mm. It was more of a docuseries.
Yeah, well, again,
HBO.
And it was very embraced, but, you know.
Who saw that?
It was pretty, I watched Torgasm. It was fantastic, but that was before I knew the person you were that was exposed in this documentary. And, listen.
You destroyed my family. You destroyed my family.
I love you as a person always.
I love you too,
always.
Dude.
But I'm just saying you've done things that you have to answer for in this world.
I mean, that's true.
Yeah.
I mean, you're scaring me because you're absolutely right about that.
You haven't been looking at the papers. You haven't watched this documentary.
No.
I can understand why you'd probably want to stay away from it.
Why would I? I don't have nothing to do with it. I'm not in R&B. I'm not into, I don't listen to the music.
Mm-hmm.
I don't listen to it.
Mm-hmm. I met him when I was 14.
I'll tell you one thing.
Sorry,
I know.
What was that?
Did you listen to the cries?
I met him when I was 14.
I don't. Why would you?
No, these are all just testimonies from people from all over this documentary that the whole crew watched. Look, you could feel the tension in the room. Everyone's uncomfortable. Young Becky Rodriguez, terrified to be in your presence. We had to promise her we'd walk her out.
But she's on my podcast.
Yeah, that's the grossest thing. That's what makes it so gross.
Why do you think she's there? She's scared.
She's right there. You're making her live in the studio, from what I understand, in this documentary.
I absolutely do not do that.
She has to sit there naked. You make her do weird stuff in front of people.
No, she takes photos when she wants. She can come and go and she does whatever she wants.
What kind of photos are these?
What I mean, the photos of me and my friends.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And sometimes, Gabby,
Robert.
Young Gabby.
Oh, young. Other people involved.
Young
not
Gabby.
Young. Other people involved. You prey on your friends' children.
Listen, you're back. Listen, you're taking this. You're getting me mixed up.
Okay? I don't think so.
She takes some photos. That's all.
I mean, do we have some clips of this documentary here that I think lead me to believe certain things?
I grew up looking up to Robert Kelly.
What do you mean?
I'm sorry, Mike. Mike did say he was going to have a hard time with this show particularly.
Well, that's why I'm sitting over here.
I said he's still the guy you know. There's just a side to him we didn't know.
I mean, this is all true. Okay? This is literally scaring me now. Like, I don't know if we're going really into my... I mean, what's happened?
You're worried if you've done this thing.
Done what? I've done nothing. I have a wife. I have a kid. I have a 3-bedroom ranch.
The evidence is pretty harsh.
I haven't done anything in 15 years.
I have a question for you.
Yes.
Do you recall Robert Kelly, young comic?
Yeah.
Young entertainer,
yes.
Should I say, on the scene.
Yes.
You had a mentor at one point, possibly, I think, a manager.
Yeah.
At some point, and he owned the Boston Comedy Club.
Yeah, Barry Katz.
Barry Katz, exactly.
Yeah.
Well, your tour manager at the time,
Matt
who
Frost.
Was out with you, I believe his name was Demetrius Smith.
Yes.
This is what he said in the documentary.
Robert said, man, we got Aaliyah in trouble. Robert mentioned to me that I think she's pregnant. And that broke my heart right there. I was so disappointed in him because I really believed him when he said that, he wasn't doing any messing with Aaliyah. I was in the room when they got married. I had papers forged for them. Aaliyah was underage.
15 years old, Robert.
Robert said I do.
15.
Yeah, I don't know that guy.
I don't know that.
Sure you
that
don't.
Guy. That's not. I've never met that. What's his name?
Demetrius Smith.
I don't know who he is. I've never met him. I don't know what he's talking about.
Perhaps you'd like to hear from your brother.
Wait, did anybody... Why does no one have the part where it said Barry, which would have made that all make sense?
Oh.
Hey, Robert, you might remember earlier in your career, there was a man named Barry Katz who was instrumental.
I don't have the Barry part.
Just say Barry.
Oh, it's interesting.
It was the whole thing was only for the Barry part.
It's interesting that all of a sudden it's not here.
Well, it was by the way, here. I will say when I came up today to the studio.
I was early.
Yeah.
And it was here.
Robert Kelly was already here.
Yeah, because I'm always early.
You were influencing DJ Lou, which is very, you could pry him with Young Pussy in a heartbeat.
And Ritz Bits crackers.
And Ritz Bits crackers. Peanut butter and or cheese.
Those are my favorites.
The cheese ones?
The cheese.
Oh, why? Because it lures the kids?
The peanut butter's one.
None of this helps. Like yeah, do we have something from his brother? Bobby, I know.
I don't have, what you mean, my little brother?
Sure.
Likes younger women. You have people who have fantasies about different things. Yeah. I like older women. Go figure. You know?
Yeah.
But that's just a preference.
Disgusting.
It's a preference. Everyone has preferences. So, what is the big deal? What's the big issue?
Cold.
With my brother.
Cold.
Jay.
Look, your brother's going to get your back. I understand that.
When my brother's, he's a redhead Irish kid from Boston. He doesn't really sound like that. Like, I don't think that was my brother.
Oh, we use the modulator,
yeah.
I think.
Auto-tune?
I think they did the Babe Ruth thing. You know, he didn't want to be, I'm sure, out there in post. So, you know,
so you made him sound like a black dude?
I did nothing. This is Lifetime Networks that has really rallied this campaign against you.
When I saw this documentary after growing up idolizing Bobby, it felt like I just learned that Santa Claus, like, kicks puppies. It was the worst thing in the world.
Like that
it broke my heart.
Because that was something, calling me a pedophile and fat. I don't... What?
You're disappointed in his weight loss and pedophilia, yes, his weight gain
exactly.
And pedophilia?
And his animal cruelty.
Go figure.
Go figure.
It breaks my fucking heart, Bobby.
Well, I'll probably reference you back to some of your finer works, as we all know. And Bobby, in fairness, this is friend talking to friend here.
Yeah.
We've had a lot of conversations.
We've had a lot
me
of conversations.
Me and you are both guys who aren't going to scoff at being involved in a little piss play. We're adults.
No,
we're adults.
I wouldn't drink a gallon of water to pee. Like, I wouldn't muster up, but if I had to go... If I had to pee, I would do it, but I wouldn't go.
You're saying you've never peed on anybody willingly?
I've never...
You really wanted to.
No. I've never peed on anybody. The only person I've ever peed on is myself.
Well, there's a videotape that I will not bring up because the girls are underage. However...
Why can I see that?
You know, some of these people...
Why did that just do it for me? Maybe...
Well, you say you've never peed on anybody, then yeah. I'd like you to possibly explain this right here. Oh,
Bobby.
Jesus Christ.
This broke my fucking heart.
That's not me.
Well, not now. Of course, this is in the 90s.
That's young Bobby.
Oh, and then this happened.
No.
Even guys got involved in peeing on you.
I wish that was me. No, that's not me. First of all.
This is all going to go at the bonfire, SXM. Full proof evidence. I mean, get the case going, Atlanta.
Pop, the documentary's out. I mean, just.
Peeing on young girls. And then also being peed on by handsome men. All of which. And yourself included, Bobby. If I got to be nice here. I'm going to say your body's fantastic. Go, let me show him what the guy's peeing.
Listen, that guy's not circumcised, Jay.
Guy's peeing, huh? No, it is circumcised. He's just pulling the trunk meat up.
They didn't even go, they didn't, what the heck is that?
Oh,
that's
Bob.
Oh, Robert Kelly.
First of all,
well, you kept it black, which is cool. I appreciate that. And let me say something. Your deltoids look ripped.
Yeah, look at that.
And I don't think that's pee, by the way, on the second one. I think you got the wrong. I think you got the wrong photo.
I think that was supposed.
I didn't strike you as this kind of guy, but look at you right there. Your dick's just touching with another guy's dicks while another man pees on you.
That's on my head, Jay.
That's what Bob. I heard that's what he wanted is the torgasm. Cover, actually.
Basically, it was very close.
It's very damning evidence here. And also, this is unrelated, but I figure we probably should just show these here.
That's not...
And And then, of course,
that's Jerry.
Oh,
things
man.
Got crazy.
Jerry.
I mean, Jesus.
Well, that's the face I would have if that happened. But,
yeah, well, it doesn't look comfortable.
What?
Yeah.
First of all, listen, this is just this is outrageous. This is outrageous.
I agree.
It totally is.
I completely agree it's outrageous.
That guy's ass is perfect.
Has nobody ever made you face these things before?
No. Broke my heart.
Oh, no. My God. Look, I can understand being grumpy after a lot of this action.
I burned your albums.
I can see after these men have done this to you that you are going to want to lash out.
I'm not. That's not. That's a square head.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, you know, you are a Boston guy.
That's a
square head of people up there. You know
butt.
What I mean?
Oh, my.
Who cares? Let me say again, Bobby, though, your body's fantastic. Well, you did lack in morality. You made up for in physical fitness.
Well, that I mean, I was
and
sexy.
Apparently ass waxing too.
Sexy Bobby,
that's a fucking clean Bobby
oh,
butt right
good
there.
Lord! Oh, every day a new nightmare.
Like a cherub fountain.
That's not my penis, guys. That's three different penises.
No, well, no, that's not. That's one penis peeing on two girls. If you can go to the next picture, please.
That's the same.
No. The original one. Yes, that's three penises, Bobby.
Listen to me, dude. I'm saying that there's three different penises on me. Go back.
No, at any given time, I assume.
Yeah, that's a light day.
First of all, this isn't even what R. Kelly was accused of.
No, I know. That's why it says we dug a little deeper.
This is the soon-to-be documentary.
This is what I'm worried about. This is the documentary I'm really worried about coming out.
Do we have any... Do we have... Oh, also, how about, Christine, do you have the screenshot? Yeah, the screenshot that got a tweet. It also, there's a part of the documentary where it talks about the people coming out against you. And funny you mentioned Tourgasm, because your own boyhood friend.
Yes.
Dane Cook.
Yeah.
By the way, check mark. This is legit.
It's really him.
Subtext way. It was like a Fellini film. I mean, he was really trying to say something without saying it.
He had
it
a Robert, lines.
If a Robert K got in trouble, that still would have been up.
Believe me, if somebody called DC got in trouble for some pedophilia, I'd have a few things to say on Twitter myself. But yeah, I think you might be right about this one. But that's just coincidence, Jay. And I, who doesn't like a young? My wife is younger.
Whoa!
Wow. Okay. She, well, here it comes.
She's not. I didn't meet her when she was.
Which
you know,
wife?
I don't know. You only let her come out and wave to us once when we come for barbecues.
From the bigger. She's from the Bilko doors.
You go take your lap.
She's cooking.
Yeah.
Hey, do you want good food?
I do.
Or do you
do
want to sit and chat to a wordy woman from Boston?
No.
You want to sit there and have that conversation?
Yeah.
So, Jay, where are you from? No, or do you want some macaroni salad that tastes good?
Well, I don't mind opening up with somebody. Maybe that's the problem here, Robert, because it shows here that you have a quote.
What?
As a kid, you had lots of secrets. Some were terrible. Some were beautiful. Some were both. Yeah. One secret about what was happening to me at home, which I assume has something to do with that last picture we showed.
That's actually from me.
That's your quote.
No, that's actually, wrote that last week on Twitter.
Fair,
that's
fair
literally on every diary I've ever had. I write that in the beginning, and then I write my address and my phone number in case I lose it.
I had my hand on the back of my head. I had scissors opened up.
I have a tattooed on my heart. on my ass right now. That's literally tattooed.
It's in brand. It's branded.
Yeah, it's in Hebrew. But
it's framed above your bed.
Yeah, and it's in black light ink.
Oh, do we have the lady speaking? Who says what she feels is more important than Robert performing is him.
No, this is just...
Protecting Robert Kelly and his ability to make music and entertain fans means more than what he did in his private life with these little girls.
Disgusting. Oh. Absolutely.
Now, here's the thing.
That's what you call a trooper.
I feel like you would think, hey, look, finally, evidence that shows how could this possibly be me.
Right, it's not me.
Robert Kelly performing his music for his fans.
Yes.
How could that be you?
Right, because I don't sing.
And then, you didn't say? She didn't say anything about singing.
Performing music
she
was
said
her
performing
quote.
Music.
Now you're changing
for her
the
fans.
Words.
And I'd say, does Robert Kelly that I know even do that? And then I refer you to this video. Right here. No, Christine. I mean, what the fuck with this production?
I mean,
I'm trying to fucking rake Robert Kelly over the coals.
If R. Kelly had them as the prosecutor, he'd win.
YouTube. Robert Kelly, drums. Mike Caltashow, pulling the curtain. Fourth wall break.
It said it was removed. It said it was removed.
Did it really?
It's up, but it said it was removed.
Oh, did it?
Yes.
Hey, look, everyone. It's Robert Kelly playing fucking music in front of fans. I guess that's more important than little black women.
Loving it.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah.
It's a sad state in the world when America thought that this particular performance was more important than little black girls.
Explains a lot. First of all, you can't. You're melting things together, Jay.
No,
you're taking a. She said perform. What did she say?
If it makes sense,
now,
Bobby.
I don't know.
If it makes sense, Bobby, I'm trying to melt things together. My crew is not helping me out. Yeah.
They are all on his side. He was here. Hey, you know what? He was here pretty early with the entire crew. Like you said before.
Yeah, it was very
weird. I think that this is a complete sabotage.
I thought somebody told him and had the video removed because it was showing up as removed video in the history. No,
that's just people who like that song protested and reported it to YouTube to get it the fuck down because Fatso was off time. Fucking fat.
I guess that's how little society cares about young black girls.
Listen, every stop other saying that.
No, it's disgusting.
Oh, man, look, you what, going
Michael,
now, huh?
Michael.
I looked up to you like like an older brother. I'm not bald. But I don't have bad vision. I'm trying just to be you, but now, fuck it.
You meant the world to me, man.
You really did.
You had beautiful blonde hair.
You were my Ned Needleender.
You're not even gray.
No,
you beautiful. Dye your hair gray.
What do you say?
Now forget it.
You're going to go back to being a beautiful little Dutch boy.
That's it.
Robert, what do you say?
First of all, stop calling me Robert. Hmm? My name is not Robert, Jay.
You prefer R. Kelly?
It's not R. Kelly, guys.
You prefer R. Dot?
No, I don't want R. Nice.
Hashtag
Bob,
time's
up. You call me Bobby.
Yeah.
Bobby with an I-E. Bobby.
I'm just trying to keep things in rhythm.
Just trying to lean in.
Is this my water in a cup?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You ever see Stern's guest drinking? You ever see Robert Downey Jr. drinking a water in a cup? What is this, before bottled water? What the fuck is
Well, water? Next time, don't give your exclusive to me. You could have taken the story to Howard Stern.
But you chickened out.
But you got afraid. Too many people here.
Why make us pull the curtains, Robert?
You guys feed people like you're in a detention center. Right. Pretzels and water in a cup.
It's like you're getting a new muffler discount.
But it's the whole bag of pretzel sticks.
You guys want to take my shoelaces, too?
It really is. Yeah, we're trying to get you used to prison food. Because I don't know if you recall, Robert, when you made your trip to Ethiopia while on tour.
I've never been to Ethiopia.
And yeah,
so
that's what
say.
I would say, too, if there wasn't evidence of it.
Does Ethiopia know that you've never been there?
We should have a bell for all the chubby jokes you guys make.
I haven't made one chubby joke.
That's a fucking Ethiopia you've never, I can tell.
No. Oh. I'm talking about the time you went to Ethiopia.
Yes.
And now the video has come out of you recruiting women.
What?
Young girls.
You're crazy.
From the audience through song.
Despicable.
Lou, what the fuck?
Are you saying this isn't you? Please play this.
Lou, don't look at him.
Passport? Did you get your shots? Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America. Do you have your passport? Did you get your shots? Girl, would you like to come back with Rob to America? America.
Here's where you really let it go, where you really wail.
Do you have your passport?
Oh, he wants
Did
these
you
young girls.
Now you're gonna say you've never been to Ethiopia?
Wow, that's pretty damning evidence.
Where are they, Rob? Where are they, Rob?
Let Becky Rodriguez go. She is not part of your cult anymore. And you let Gabby out too while you're at it. She didn't even tell me she was back in town, Gabby. Gabby's, you got her so brainwashed.
Gabby's dad owes me.
He lost the bar bet.
He's got some secrets. Listen, that was fucking... That, first of all, that was beautifully... I mean, it was fucking hilarious.
Great case.
But that was... I mean, that song... You just had a dude at the end.
Can I do my closing?
You can't...
Can I do my closing statements to the argument now?
Wait a minute. What closing statements? I don't even have a lawyer.
I was pleading a case.
No lawyer would take your case.
I have no lawyer. I have nobody on my side. You have Becky saying she's a hottage.
You should have thought about that before you pee on these young women.
Yeah, you pissed your case right down the toilet, son.
Ladies and gentlemen of the room, Becky.
Why is Jacob, she separate?
I'm saying Becky, Jake. No, I was going to name everybody. Black Lou, DJ Lou.
Yes.
Christine, you'll be too impartial. You're my girlfriend. Mike, you're a little too disappointed for this.
Broke my fucking heart.
I play to you, the people of the room. Picture a young black girl wanders into a smoky comedy club one night and sees a statuesque, ripped young Robert Kelly wearing a tight motorcycle jacket. When he lifts his hand to wave to her, his t-shirt comes up and you see that little V that goes down to his dick that we all wish we had.
I just came.
And he, yeah. And then he invites this young black girl into a studio that's got a weird side room attached to it. But doesn't matter to her. I'm with my idol. I'm seeing this man who I've idolized comedically and entertainment-wise for so long. And then he proceeds to pee all over her, running down her little weird body. Now,
what the?
Now, I want you to picture that little girl as white. I rest my case. I just time to killed you, bro. You just got time to killed.
I'm guilty.